green bin and a regular trash bin, I'm hoping it can be considered that the regular trash bin can be used for yard waste and food waste. Due to the fact that I hear a lot of residents complaining about the expensive yard waste bags and that they're very flimsy. You just pick them up and you lose everything on your driveway. And they're very heavy for seniors, so I'm hoping the regular trash cans, since they're already going to be out there in the households, they can be used for yard waste and for food waste. And then the recycling bin can be used for recyclables and regular household trash. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Councilor Pennington.
Thank you. Council, I think, has really covered this. I know Mr. Lester did it very comprehensively, but first of all, I want to thank you for your efforts to extend recycling. I, like the other council members, get the inquiries about when can we get, you know, our recycling bin. So it's a good day for the people who are supposed to get these. But I think it's implicit in what you said that you have made a cost-benefit analysis to determine whether, you know, this is an appropriate thing to do, whether spending $5 million in light of the fact that there might be a change in the method of pickup. Is that right?
Yes, sir. And if I could create a gulf, if you would, between, I mean, what the one bin grant is, a study, as Councilman Bradford indicated, of positives and negatives and costs of the system, and to really create a decision matrix for any municipality to very easily determine if this is something that they could do in their market area. And so that is the victory of the $1 million grant, whether it fits here or not. I mean, that is a victory that we will claim for one million.
Yeah, but the cost-benefit analysis would be the value of landfill savings and that could happen over the next year.
And then
the value of the use of the bins when you do, if you do begin the one bin. So that's kind of an
answer.
Yes. Thank you very much.
Councilor Wynn.
Thank you, Mayor. Good morning, Director.
Good morning.
How optimistic are you about the one bin for all project?
Councilmember, we're not talking today about one bin for all.
Yes, sir.
Councilmember, it is a process that we are going through, and I think there will be a decision that you will receive.
So in the meantime, this is not a sure thing.
No, sir.
Right. So these bins are serving their purpose. The purchasing we're making today.
Absolutely.
So that means I'm still waiting for my green bin, and you have my support.
Thank you.
That's
Councilman Martin.
Thank you, Mayor. Thank you, Director. Appreciate the comments. Even though that hasn't been on the agenda, there has been some discussion about a garbage service fee tax, whatever you want to call it, attached to a water bill, and I'm not sure where that is in the process. My question to you is, there ever been any discussion as we go to items not in 10 are connected at the hip? So when you look at it, you look at $10 million of an expense for a department that collects zero revenue. Has there ever been any discussion, and I represent an area that outsources solid waste to commercial waste collectors. So when we need a garbage collection bin, we go out and purchase it ourselves. So my question, has there ever been any discussion about consumers purchasing their garbage bins since we give away everything in the garbage collection business, and yet we're going to give them a bin to put their waste in?
No, sir. We have not had that discussion. And if I may, part of that is based on the design of our collection system so that it can be uniform. And we have reduced the number of personnel from 1,300 to 450 to gather these efficiencies.
Right, but in the district I represent, we have water bills. We don't have solid waste collection. So if the city has an attempt to attach a fee onto a water bill where we receive no services for, as you and I discussed,
yes,
I would be adamantly opposed to that.
Yes, sir.
So my question is, in a way to recoup revenue in lieu of what we see as a $150 million deficit, I was curious as to why that discussion didn't take place.
Well, we can take that out of consideration, Captain.
And just to clarify, we are talking about $5 million and change. It's not $10 million. Item 9 is the appropriation, and item 10 is the purchasing authority.
Yes, sir.
Not those particular items.
Correct.
Councilmember Kulas.
I'd like to thank Councilmember Lassiter for expressing how people like the bins. I need to hear that. I heard that we were going to be reimbursed. Mayor Pro Tem Gonzalez, you said we were going to be recoup our expenses. Where do we recoup these expenses?
Basically, with the purchase of these cards, they will be reimbursed by revenue derived from the sale of recycled material and from the avoided cost of disposal of landfill material.
How long will it take us to recoup $5 million?
And it doesn't specify here that it'll be the full amount, so Director, I don't know if you know.
Councilmember, we do these 7 years for the trucks and 10 years for the carts. That's how we work with the finance department to reduce the cost for the.
So with these 95,000 bins, we're going to get trucks too?
Oh, not for the $5 million, no, sir. The trucks is a separate purchase item, I believe.
So you're going to be coming back wanting trucks?
Not wanting trucks, Councilmember, needing trucks to provide the service.
Well, how much is that going to cost?
I believe that amount is $2.5 or $2.6 million.
So it's getting close to that $10 million that Councilmember Martin had mentioned, so. Who will get the bins? Will everybody? Everybody's going to get a bin?
Everybody that does not have a bin currently, a little over 95,000 homes that we provide direct service to.
So all of them are going to get a bin?
Everybody.
Everybody in District D is going to get a bin?
Everybody gets a bin.
Okay.
Everybody.
And has anyone been arrested for stealing these bins?
I'm aware of people that have been arrested for using the bins to steal. Within neighborhoods.
I know Director is laughing here, but the truth of the matter is
that is the truth.
20,000 bins a year.
That's between the black carts and the green carts. Yes, sir, Councilman.
My God, there's got to be a stack of them somewhere. 20,000. Wow. Okay. Thank you very much.
And just to be clear again, Councilmember Martin's comment was correct based on the online version. It does show an appropriation of $10 million, but that wasn't that was a burden on our part.
Okay.
The actual appropriation is $5 million. So you were correct. We're trying to clarify the discrepancy.
So just to clarify, when we come to 10, there probably has to be an amendment to that. Is that not correct? Since it does say appropriation of $5 million. I'm not sure.
The motion.
Thank you.
The motion language is correct.
Thanks.
Councilor McCoy.